Del Tufo was out there in Jersey rolling up on people saying, hey, check out my arm. Do you like music?
Oh, I was mixing down at the Jersey Shore before the Jersey Shore
Hold
people.
On, like a little bit deeper on this ink that you have. When did you get it?
Ooh, it's
because I got to tell you what, I had known you at least 5, 6, 7 years before I even knew that you just popped open your shirt sleeve one day here a few years ago. And I was like, what is that on your arm? And you're like, oh, no, I have a tattoo. It says music. And I'm just like, you what? You would be the last person on earth, I would suspect, of having ink.
I had a girlfriend that she was a big tattoo part. Like, she had, you know, sleeves and stuff. And she's like, get a tattoo. And I went, guy that she knew, boom, did it.
And you're like, oh, okay, sure, music.
But I was like, what do you want to do on it? Like, you know, I should get the established 1966, like,
You should get movies and television, sports,
radio,
politics, food,
mixing,
DJing.
I wanted to put
you
like
should
a,
just get like the a, Delta console when you sit in the flight and the screen comes up and you got your music options, film, TV series.
So I want to run this down. Like, so you were like, okay, she convinced you to do it.
Yeah, and I went and did it.
And then you went Boom. And just immediately did it?
Yeah. No, there
like
was nothing.
Same day? Was it over the course of a week?
No, because you got to make an appointment with this guy.
Okay.
It took like
so
2 days.
So it took like a month or something?
No, 2 days.
And then so it's very large too. So you decided to go straight arm,
yeah,
upper
so you
arm.
Hide it if you need that.
So it's hidden under like a polo shirt. You didn't want like your shoulder or your leg or anything?
No, everyone says the back here is like really painful.
Oh, so you were looking shoulder. At... least pain possible.
Exactly.
I'm surprised you didn't go in and say, I'll take the Udonis Haslam, please, and get the entire state of Florida tattooed on your back.
The true cool. story.
You the closest I ever got to a tattoo, I feel okay to tell this story today because it's his birthday. Shout out to Sean Carey, my oldest friend, Jock Street. We were juniors in high school, went downtown. We were very into Chris Herren. Massachusetts
oh,
guy,
yeah,
by Fall
course.
River, Fall River Dreams,
great
written
story,
by Bill Reynolds,
Chris
one of the great sports books of all time. We loved that story. Chris was a figure of inspiration for us. Sean's uncle was an assistant coach on those Fresno teams out there with Jerry Tarkanian, that Chris played on with Rafer Alston, I think Melvin Eli, and some characters on those teams. So my buddy Sean would go out in the summer times in high school and train with those guys. And he got to know Chris Herren.
Wow.
So in high school, we thought it was a really good idea to go down to Union Square in New York City and find a tattoo parlor and get the Chris Herren tattoo. Now, we thought it was a good idea, but Sean was the one going to get the tattoo. And again, happy birthday, Jock Street. It's his birthday today. And he got the Chris Herren tattoo, which is his name in Gaelic writing. And a shamrock on his arm. But it turns out that the tattoo that Sean got is Old English writing, so it's not the exact same. And then it's a four-leaf clover, which apparently Irish people just are not fans of, like, at all. So it's kind of off.
Oops.
And 20 years later, as fate would have it, he showed that tattoo to Chris Herren. And the look of horror on Herren's face that he had inspired someone at a young age to make such a poor decision... was horrifying, but then he was reminded that, well, Chris could have inspired some other poor decisions, so if that was the worst of it,
other very,
got
very
out.
Poor decisions.
Okay, but it's always great when he busts out the carry.
So he
tattoo.
Still has it? He didn't
it's
get
a
it
tattoo,
removed?
Brockman.
Yeah, but you can get those removed now.
What do you mean? It's a
you
tattoo.
You can get them removed.
Can That's
you,
a process, though.
Yeah,
it's a process.
Have you ever gone close? Did you ever think about it?
Never thought about it. Not once. There's nothing I want permanently on my body that. I couldn't imagine. Not a big fan of the pain. I mean, I have no problem with needles, but not into the like.
It actually wasn't as bad as you thought.
Also, the idea of like, I'm going to get this thing that's going to take. I'm just going to sit in this chair for 7 hours. While they
it doesn't
do this.
Take that long.
It depends what you get.
I mean,
when I was going out into Vegas like, all the time, I used to see some really good ones out in Vegas. My favorite one was the chicken nugget on the forearm and the barbecue sauce on the bicep. So you would dunk the nugget.
Oh, that is fantastic. See, those are that's
pretty
cool.
strong, actually.
I
see,
like
that's
that.
Hilarious.
I'm actually like, just the other day was the 5-year anniversary of the only tattoo I ever got. So I got it 5 years ago, like this week.
What did you get? Trust the process?
No, it was, I told you guys before, my nephew at 9 years old passed away. What happened is when he turned on his 18th birthday, I went and got his name tattooed here. My boy G-Spot tattoo I got his name tattooed here on my forearm.
You think that's an emotional connection to something in your life that's part of your life journey, and it was very challenging for you and still is to this day.
Yeah,
and that's
for sure.
That's obviously very personal, important. Or you can get music.
I also feel like...
I would Tom Brady. I should get on this arm because I love Tom Brady now.
Like, he now loves getting stuff we like.
Del Tufo loves Tom Brady the way you now love the Lakers. It was one of those type of things.
Listen,
right?
I remember going to the forum. You know, we would go first to Nate Nows in Beverly Hills and see Dr. Buss, see Jerry and all the gang, Linda Rambis. You know, and we'd all go down to the forum. So many memories hanging out there at the forum with Diane Sharon and Jack. Every Laker fan gives you their resume.
Of course.
I've learned that in my short time in Los Angeles.
I
was there for Shaq and Kobe. I was there for the alley-oop. Apparently, Staples Center holds 100,000 people.
Exactly.
Apparently. Yeah. Did you know that the night that Kobe scored 60 points in his last game, there were 200,000 people at Staples Center? I've met 150,000.
It's so true.
Watch that
in New York, that used to be funny when we were kids because people would say they were at everything. Like, you went to this, you went to that.
What's going on? We got breaking news. Brockman does have a tattoo?
He does.
He does? Well, yes. That's why you can't buy him here at the Rich Eisen Show.
I knew it.
That looked like it hurts.
Oh,
man.
Wow.
It's bust a great it out. Bust it out, Brockman.
Rich Brockman.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.